Hi, for my PhD, I'm working with oranges and I'm making useful materials from them. I know it sounds fun, but it's not about fun, it's about saving our planet. So probably you know that most of materials are made from crude oil. And probably you know that we are using crude oil much faster than nature can produce for us. And that's a big problem because that means that one day you would need to choose between having a drink in a plastic bottle, sitting on a comfortable chair, or being able to produce medicines. And I'm going to be honest with you, I don't want to choose. And that's why it's so important to look for other resources which we can use instead of crude oil. That's why I'm working with oranges. Or more specifically, I'm working with compounds which you can extract from oranges. I'm working with terpenes. Terpenes are essential oils of plants, which give them their characteristic smell. What is more exciting, terpenes are everywhere. So I already mentioned you oranges, but they are also in other plants, pine trees, apples. Some of terpenes can be produced by bacteria, you know, these teeny tiny organisms. So the point is, there is a lot of terpenes and we can use them to make useful materials. For my PhD, I'm making polyurethanes from oranges. So now probably you are thinking, what are polyurethanes? Think about the chair which you are sitting on. Under the layer of material, there is a polyurethane foam which makes this chair so comfortable. So step by step, how to make polyurethanes from oranges. You will need four things. Oranges, or actually just orange peel, so it's like eating an orange and still having an orange. Hydrogen peroxide, the same which can be used for bleaching hair. CO2, a gas which is emitted in huge quantities by cars. And the nitrogen-containing compounds. So first, terpenes have to be extracted from orange peel. Then they can react with hydrogen peroxide and attach oxygen to itself. After adding oxygen, we can react it with CO2, which will make a ring, which contains one CO2 and one oxygen. And this ring can be easily opened by nitrogen-containing compounds, resulting in polyurethanes. And that's just beginning. Who knows what more terpenes can do? Maybe in the future we could have armchairs or jumpers made from terpenes, or maybe even paracetamol could be made from terpenes. Terpenes have huge unexplored potential, and that's why I'm using them to make useful materials, which hopefully will help us to reduce the amount of crude oil which we use, which means we don't need to compromise our lifestyle. At the end, I will tell you a secret, but it's between you and me, all right? Paracetamol from oranges is possible. Thank you.